everyone, today we would be discussing the daily MCQs of July 23, 2018, and these MCQs are very, very important for the upcoming RBI examinations. So let's begin with the first question. Which state has launched the digital armies to curb the incidence of lynching and violence due to fake news? Recently, we have come across so many incidents of lynching and violence due to the spread of the fake news. Therefore, Uttar Pradesh has come up with this initiative of digital armies. And as a part of this initiative, all the 1469 police stations, 1469 police stations in Uttar Pradesh will have the WhatsApp group, which will comprise of 250 members. And who all will be at these 250 members? So the ex-servicemen or the teachers, the doctors, advocates and journalists would be the part of this group of 250 members, and these digital volunteers. So these teachers, doctors or the journalists will be known as the digital volunteers, and they would inform the nearest police station if they come across any fake news on the social media, and at the same time they would disseminate the correct information among the locals so that they could curb the spread of rumors and fake news. The next question is, which state has launched the Thai canteen giving away meals at rupees 6? So after Amma canteens in Tamil Nadu and Indira canteens in Karnataka, Maharashtra has come up with the Thai canteen initiative. If we wish to guess the answer for this question, then we know that elder sister is known as Thai in Marathi language. Therefore, we could just guess the answer Maharashtra. If we talk about this Thai canteen initiative, then under this initiative, the meal would be of rupees 6, where sabzi would be given at rupees 4 and roti would be given at rupees 2, totaling to the rupees 6 a meal, and the canteen will be run in two shifts, afternoon and evening. Besides this, the food packets of women self-help groups will be available at these Thai canteens. Next question is, which state has topped the public affairs index 2018? This is an important question. According to this question, Kerala stands at the first position as the best governed state in the country for the third time, and this is not the first time. So the first index was launched in 2016, another in 2017, and this is for the 2018. So for the third time, Kerala has topped the list, and it has topped the list in the large states. So there are two categories under this Public Affairs Index 2018, the first one being the large states and second one the smaller states, where the smaller states are those states where the population is below 2 crores. Now, among the large states category, Kerala has been ranked first position, followed by Tamil Nadu and Telangana. If we look at the states at the lowest position, then Bihar has been ranked at the lowest position with 18th rank due to the economic inequalities and higher social inequalities in the state. If we look at the smaller states, then Himachal Pradesh has been ranked at the first position, followed by Goa and Mizoram. The lowest state or the lowest ranked state among the smaller states is Meghalaya, ranked at the 12th position. Let's talk about this Public Affairs Index 2018. So this index was on the governance and was released by the Bengaluru-based Public Affairs Center, which is a think tank. And it was based on 10 themes, 30 focus subjects and 100 indicators. Not so important, but the name of the think tank is important and the categorization along with the ranking is important. Another question is, NCERT has initiated the process of introducing dash in the textbooks. So NCERT has initiated the process of introducing QR code, which is quick response code, in the textbooks. This is how the QR code looks like, and this is aimed at helping students so that they could understand the chapters better by watching the film or reading additional content on laptops or on the digital boards. Now, what is this QR code? So QR code is a two-dimensional machine readable barcode. It is a machine readable barcode which consists of array of black and white squares. So you could see that there are black and white squares in this QR code. Next question is Medini Puraskar Yojana. So this Medini Puraskar Yojana has been reintroduced by the Environment Ministry, and this is associated with the literature. So under this scheme or awards, Indian authors would be awarded for their original work in Hindi. This is important. So this award would be given in the Hindi literature, and the work would include the compositions on the environment, pollution and climate change subjects. These award been reintroduced so that they could encourage the Hindi authors to write on the environmental topics. Under this award, the first prize would be awarded rupees 1 lakh. Second would be given rupees 75,000. And the third would be awarded rupees 50,000. Next question is, what is the name of the first of its kind air quality and weather forecast system inaugurated by Dr. Harshvardhan? Dr. Harshvardhan is our Environment and Forest Climate Minister. And he has inaugurated this SAFAR, which is a system of air quality and weather forecasting. Now, what is this SAFAR? So it has a giant two color LED display, which gives out a real-time air quality index on 24/7, which is all the time air quality index would be provided on this LED display. And it would accelerate the public awareness and the preparedness of the air pollution under the weather extremes. What is the name of the satellite which Facebook is planning to launch? Facebook is planning to launch a satellite which is known as Athena. So the social network is working on the internet satellite. So this Athena would be internet satellite. And what is the use of this internet satellite? So that they could efficiently provide the broadband access to the unserved and the undeserved areas throughout the world. And they are also planning it to launch by the early 2019. The next question is, who among the following won gold medal at Badminton Asia Junior Championships 2018? This is a very important question, as Lakshya Sen has become the only third Indian to secure a gold medal at this event. So before this, there were two people who secured gold medal at this event. First one being late Gautam Thakkar in the year 1965. And another one is Olympic silver medalist PV Sindhu. She won the medal in 2012. These are the only three people, late Gautam Thakkar, PV Sindhu and Lakshya Sen, who have won gold medal at this event. This Badminton Asia Junior Championships 2018 was held in Jakarta, which is in Indonesia. Next question is, what are the names of the mascots of Tokyo 2020 Paralympics and Olympics respectively? Important part is, the name of the mascots have been asked respectively for the Paralympics and the Olympics. So there are two confusing options over here, the Somyati and Miraitova. Miraitova and Somyati. So for Tokyo 2020 Paralympics, Somyati has been chosen as the mascot. And for the Tokyo 2020 Olympics, Miraitova has been named as the mascot. So this is Somyati, which is pink checkered, and this is Miraitova, which is blue checkered. And this Miraitova has been inspired from the official logo of Tokyo 2020 Paralympics, which is again in the blue and the white color. And what about this Somyati? So Somyati represents the cherry blossom and has been inspired, or has been inspired from cherry blossom. Another two options, which are Suhurang and Bandabi. Suhurang was the official mascot of 2018 Winter Olympics. This is Suhurang and this is Bandabi. And this Bandabi is the 2018 mascot of Paralympics. Winter Paralympics, this is important. And these 2018 Winter Olympics and 2018 Paralympics were held in South Korea. The last question for today is, who has been declared as the 2017 Player of the Year by the All India Football Federation? So Sunil Chhetri has been declared as Player of the Year by AIFF, All India Football Federation. And the Women Footballer of the Year was Kamala Devi. She is Kamala Devi and he is Sunil Chhetri. This is all for today. I hope you like the lecture. For more such videos, please subscribe to the channel Anuj Jindal. I would be happy to receive your feedback in the comment section below so that we can improve more on our videos and the content. You can also join our YouTube community. Apart from this, there are Facebook, Telegram and WhatsApp group named as Success RBI and Success SBI, which you can join and attempt the daily current affairs quiz over there as well. You can follow us on Twitter as well. Apart from this, we have Android app on Google Play Store named Infinity, which you can download and easily access all the courses and material on your mobile phones. Thank you.